Hello friends. In the last video, we had seen cluster observations analysis with the help of a practical example in MinitApp. In this video, we are going to learn the seventh tool of multivariate analysis, that is, cluster variables analysis, with the help of a practical example in MinitApp for easy understanding and better clarity. So, let's begin. Cluster variables analysis. The cluster variables analysis is used to group variables into clusters that share common characteristics. Clustering variables allows you to reduce the number of variables for analysis. Similar to cluster observations, this analysis is also appropriate when you do not have any initial information about how to form the groups. For example, a social scientist wants to study the effects of the number of media outlets, universities, and the literacy rate on the college admissions of the population. For 10 cities around the world, the scientist determines the number of newspaper copies, radios, and television sets per 1,000 people. The scientist also records the literacy rate and whether a university is in each city. The scientist wants to reduce the total number of variables by combining variables with similar characteristics. Therefore, a scientist uses the cluster variables analysis. Similar to cluster observations, cluster variables analysis also uses a hierarchical procedure to form the clusters. Variables are grouped that are similar or correlated with each other. At each step, two clusters are joined until just one cluster is formed at the final step. MinitApp calculates similarity and distance values for the clusters at each step to help you select the final grouping of variables. You can also display a dendrogram to visualize the clustering results at each step. Data considerations for cluster variables analysis. To ensure that your results are valid, consider the following guidelines when you collect data, perform the analysis, and interpret your results. The data consideration for cluster variables analysis is the same as that of cluster observations analysis. 1. You can have raw data or a matrix of distances. Usually, you use raw data for this analysis. Each row contains measurements on a single item or subject. You must have two or more numeric columns, with each column representing a different measurement. You must delete rows that have missing data from the worksheet before you use this analysis. 2. The data must be numeric. To form the clusters, this analysis calculates the distance between observations, which cannot be measured between levels of a categorical variable. To use a categorical variable in the analysis, you must first convert the text values to a numerical scale. For example, an analyst measures customer satisfaction using the categories very satisfied, satisfied, unsatisfied, and very unsatisfied. To perform cluster variables analysis, the analyst records these categories as +2, +1, -1, -2. Example of cluster variables analysis. Let's continue with the same example. A social scientist wants to study the effects of the number of media outlets, universities, and the literacy rate on the college admissions of the population. For 10 cities around the world, the scientist determines the number of newspaper copies, radios, and television sets per 1,000 people. The scientist also records the literacy rate and whether a university is in each city. The scientist wants to reduce the total number of variables by combining variables with similar characteristics. Therefore, a scientist uses cluster variables analysis. Conduct cluster variables analysis in MinitApp. To conduct a cluster variables analysis in MinitApp, please follow the steps. 1. Enter or copy the data to the MinitApp worksheet, as shown in the picture. 2. Select stat. multivariate, and then cluster variables. 3. In variables or distance matrix, enter newspaper, radios, TV sets, literacy rate, and university. 4. From linkage method, select average. The distance between two clusters is the mean distance between a variable in one cluster and a variable in the other cluster. Whereas the single and complete linkage methods are based on single pair distances, the average linkage method uses a more central measure of location. 5. Under distance measure, select correlation. The correlation method gives distances between 0 and 1 for positive correlations and between 1 and 2 for negative correlations. If it makes sense to consider negatively correlated data to be farther apart than positively correlated data, use the correlation method. 6. In specify final partition by, keep all the default setting as it is. It indicates the criteria that you want to use to determine the final groupings. Select the option of number of clusters to enter the number of clusters for the final partition. And select the option of similarity level to enter the similarity level for the clusters in the final partition. 7. Select show dendrogram. Select this option to display a tree diagram that shows how clusters were formed at each step in the amalgamation procedure. The dendrogram allows you to view the similarity or distance values for the clusters at each step. And 8. Click OK in each dialog box to get the results. We will get the results of an analysis in the session window and graph window. Interpretation of results. The table shows the clusters that were joined at each step, the distance between the cluster, and the similarity of the clusters. The similarity level decreases slightly from step 1, 93.9666, to step 2, 93.1548, then decreases suddenly in step 3, 87.3150, when the number of clusters changes from 3 to 2. The distance between the joined clusters increases slightly by approximately 0.017 from step 1 to step 2, then increases suddenly in step 3, when the number of clusters changes from 3 to 2. The distance and similarity results indicate that three clusters are reasonably sufficient for the final partition. If a social scientist thinks that this grouping makes intuitive sense, then it is probably a good choice. The dendrogram displays the information from the table in the form of a tree diagram. The social scientist should rerun the analysis and specify three clusters in the final partition. When you specify a final partition, Minitab displays additional tables that describe the characteristics of each cluster included in the final partition. This is all about the detailed illustration of cluster variables analysis. We will see the next type of multivariate tools with a practical example in the next video. For references, I have taken some part of this very detailed content from Minitab. Now to end, please like this video if you have found it useful. Add your valuable comments, share this video with your friend and colleagues to improve and refresh their knowledge. If you want to get updates of such videos from our channel, please do not forget to subscribe to it. Click on the bell icon and select to get all notifications. And finally, thank you for watching.